Muslim. He's a Christian gentleman. No bad language from him. No bad language from me. This is the way it should be. Okay, so we Muslims, we believe in our Holy Quran. And so, as a Christian, do you believe in your Bible?
Of course I do.
A bit loudly.
Of course I do.
Okay.
If I don't believe in the Bible, I won't hold it. I won't go with it anywhere I want to go.
Okay, so you think your Bible from the beginning to the end is holy?
I don't think from the beginning and the Bible, according to your statement, this is the word of God.
Okay.
Everything that has got to do with God
yeah.
is perfect and holy.
Okay. So that Bible in your hand is the Protestant Bible with 66 books, yes?
It's not written here in any Bible, whether it's a Protestant or Catholic, it's not written. What you see is written Holy Bible.
Okay.
So your statement, you have to withdraw it.
I won't withdraw it. Let me tell you. The Muslim over there knows there are how many surahs? 114 in our Quran. These Muslims know that in our Holy Quran, there are 114 surahs. No more, no less. So every Quran in the world is same from beginning to the end. Surah Al-Fatiha, the first surah, and Surah An-Nas, the mankind, the last surah. Okay, sir. That Bible you have has got 66 books. So it is not the same as other Bibles because the Catholic Christians, their Bible has 73 books. Your Bible has how many books?
When you read the Bible, you find out the words are the same. Unless some words are added, which is not supposed to be, man can corrupt anything.
Man
can corrupt, whether it be the Bible or the Quran or anything.
No, no.
They can.
Okay, thank you very much for that. Let me answer you. No man, no one can corrupt our Quran. Why?
Then
thank you very much. I'm answering.
All right.
No one can corrupt our Holy Quran. Why? Because in our Quran, in Surah Al-Hijr, the Rocky Tract, which is Surah chapter number 15, ayah verse number 9. Allah says, Inna nahnu nazzalna zikra wa inna lahu lahafizun. Allah tells us, He has revealed the Quran and He is the guardian of the Quran. That is why the Quran is the same as it was revealed more than 1400 years ago to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? So,
I don't believe that. Now you tell me.
Okay.
Why was the first copy of the Quran that was written in leaves, why did they burn them?
Okay, hold on.
If it is a perfect book and it's got no change, why should they burn it?
Hold on. The Quran was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ayahs, verses, as it was required. Okay? And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam could not write. Okay? So what was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the ayahs, the verses, he was able to memorize. Okay? And what the Prophet memorized, it was written on leaves, on bones, okay, things like that, okay, on hides of animals. But later on, it was because so many people became Muslim, so it became necessary to have the Holy Quran in book form. So during the Khilafa of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, all the writings were collected together, and it was the Holy Quran came into book form like we have today. So that's why the Holy Quran is same everywhere. Okay, but your Bible, why I emphasize, in our Quran, the first surah Al-Fatiha, the opening. In our Quran, the last surah An-Nas, the mankind. So 140 surahs. everywhere, anywhere in our Quran. But your Bible is not the same everywhere. Why? Well, because, let me finish, thank you. Why? Because the Bible you are holding has 66 books. And the Catholic Christian Bible has 73 books. And the Ethiopian, Abyssinian, Tewahedo Bible, Orthodox Bible has 81 books. And the Greek Orthodox Bible has 78 books. And the Russian Orthodox Bible has 86 books. And there are...
How many books does it and, have? How many books does
and
it have?
There are other books, okay, and there are other Christian different Bibles with different number of books, okay? As far as we were debating, but you asked a question, let me answer you. In each and every Christian Bible, they have the Old Testament and they have the New Testament. The Old Testament in the Bible is the Jewish book, the Tanakh. The Jewish holy book, the Tanakh, the Psalms, okay? And other Jewish holy scripture. But what is in the Old Testament, these Christians will give us verses. They say, oh, in the Old Testament, in this verse, oh, that is saying that Jesus was God. But no Jew in the world ever believed or does believe that Jesus was God.
Thomas,
okay. All right, one Christian at a time. Excuse me. Here comes the crusader. Crusader, be quiet.
Okay.
Brother, there's a debate. Brother,
ask you a question.
You are in front of the camera now. Okay.
How many books did Jews have? That's all I'm asking.
Okay. They have the Zabur revealed. Psalms revealed to the prophet Dawood alayhi salam, David peace be upon him, and of course they have the Zabur. Okay,
you are repeating yourself. In, you're not answering.
Okay, hold on.
How many books the Jews have?
There are many Bible. Excuse me. Hold on. I am telling you all the books in the Old Testament, all the books in the Old Testament, they are the Jewish books, but they have one book, it's called the Tanakh, okay, the Jews called Tanakh, they call it the Old Testament, okay, and in the Jewish Tanakh is the previous books which were revealed to the prophets before, they are in the Old Testament. In the New Testament they have is mostly all written by Paul, okay, who was a Jew and he wrote most of the New Testament which is in the Christian Bible. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir. Have a nice day. Okay, let's come back to you. Okay, sir, where does it say in your Bible that Jesus is God? Give me an example from your Bible.
There are a lot of scriptures that tell us that Jesus is God. I mentioned this before.
Yeah.
And it seems like you don't listen.
No, I'm listening.
I said in the Gospel of John.
Yes.
What is it written?
What?
In the beginning was the Word.
Yeah.
And the Word was with God.
Okay.
And the Word was God.
Okay.
All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made.
Okay.
Even in Isaiah.
Yeah.
In the book of Isaiah.
Old Testament.
And it said 9:6, and to us a son will be born, his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Prince of Peace, Almighty God, Everlasting Father.
Okay,
remember,
stop there.
Isaiah is one of the greatest prophets. Every prediction that he made,
okay,
he came to pass.
Okay.
He's one of the major prophets in the Old Testament.
Can you stop there? The Christian gentleman, he mentioned from the Jewish book, Jewish scriptures, from the Old Testament, that in the book of Isaiah, he said it mentions that Jesus is God.
I've just read it for you.
Yes.
And
So why is it?
You don't understand it.
So what I do? So why is it?
Why are you asking me?
Okay, hold on, hold on.
This is not
hold
my
on.
Word.
Hold on.
It's God's word.
Yeah. Okay. But why is it that you have quoted from the book of Isaiah, which is in the Old Testament?
Because the Old Testament and the New Testament is the word of God, the Bible.
Okay.
You can't separate.
Okay. Will you agree with me that in each and every Christian Bible, the Old Testament is the Jewish Tanakh? Is that true?
I will not agree with you in any way.
Why?
I have to agree with what the Word of God says.
Well, that's what
because
the Jews tell us.
You don't know the Bible.
Okay, we
then
know.
Do you know who Jesus is?
Yeah,
that's
we
why
know.
You're running around like a rabbit.
Am I running around?
Yes,
why
you
insult? Why you say like a rabbit? Do I look like a rabbit to you? Why you Christian crusaders insult us? Use nice language, okay? Our prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said the best of you is the best in manners. Okay? That's for us Muslims. The Prophet said, Muhammad, peace be upon him, the best of you is the best in manners. This is a Christian preacher. He just called me a rabbit. Is that supposed to be good manners?
I did call you a rabbit. I said,
no,
you
come on, you
like
did.
A rabbit.
No, am I running? I'm standing on
you
my
see,
chair.
Man,
did
you,
I run?
You,
I never run. Okay, let's come back.
And you are not really certain.
Let's come back.
Of what you believe in.
Let's come back. We are certain. Let's come back. So, is it true that you believe in your Bible?
My friend, you have asked this question many times.
Okay.
And I've answered you.
Yeah.
Unless you've forgotten.
Okay, so you believe it.
If I don't believe it, why should I hold it?
Okay, let me tell you. In each and every Christian Bible, in the book of Acts, which is in the New Testament, chapter 3, verse 18, Peter, the disciple of Jesus, Peter, is quoted as saying, but this is how God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, saying that his Messiah would suffer. Is this true?
Of course it is true.
So when in your Bible it says, but this is how God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, saying that his Messiah would suffer. So, excuse me, in this one verse, it is written God. And in the same verse is written Messiah. Can I ask you,
go ahead.
Who is this God mentioned in this verse?
First of all, you have to know who God is. Before you
Allah
talk
subhanahu
about,
wa ta'ala.
No, it's not just the matter of saying Allah wa ta'ala, whatever.
Yeah, we are confident.
You got to have a revelation of who the Creator is.
Yeah, who is it?
And Jesus gave us a very good description.
Yeah, go on.
Jesus said, God the Creator of the heavens and the earth is a spirit.
So,
and they that worship him, they must worship him in spirit and in truth.
So Jesus
that is
said
a description of a supernatural God who created the heavens and the earth.
So that supernatural God you just talked about, that supernatural God who Jesus talked about, Jesus talked about that supernatural God, yes?
Yes.
So is
Allahu Akbar.
Brother camera.
Yeah, come here,
so is that supernatural God Jesus?
I will say to you today that Jesus is God on the flesh. The reason is, even the Quran agree with us, and the way they put it, they believe it. We might not believe the way you put it in your Quran. In Surah Maryam, he said, Isa, the son of Maryam, was taken up by Allah and is coming back again.
Yeah.
The quotation of that Surah, we don't agree, because we know that Jesus is the Son of God.
Okay.
And not only that, the angel came to Mary and Elizabeth, and he gave a word of prediction that a son shall be born
in the land of Israel, and his name shall be called Emmanuel. And the interpretation of that word means God with us.
Okay.
God with us. That is the interpretation.
Okay.
And also I mentioned the word of John, which you don't believe.
Okay, hold on.
Chapter 1, go ahead.
Hold on. We Muslims believe in our Quran, and it tells us, Kul huwallahu ahad, say Allah, He is one. As a Christian, every Muslim believes there's only one God Almighty, one. One means one. Not two, not three, but one, always. I'm asking you, in your Bible, does it tell you that God Almighty is only one?
Yes, yes, yes. The Bible tells us in the Old Testament,
yes,
that hear, O ye Israel,
yeah,
the Lord our God is one Lord. We have one God, not three.
Okay. Which verse did you quote there?
What do you mean, which verse?
You just quoted a verse. From which book?
It is both in the Old Testament, yeah, and the New Testament.
You don't know. Let me tell you. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 4, it says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one.
Yes.
That is the verse you quoted.
Yes.
Okay. And then, did you say it's only written in the Old Testament that the God is one?
Well, it's written also. You remember, Jesus came,
yeah,
not to change the law, but to fulfill it.
Okay.
This is also written. There's some word in the Old Testament,
yeah,
which is referred to in the New Testament.
Okay.
Now, let me tell you that. Why did the prophet says, Hear, O ye Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord.
Yeah.
The reason why they mention that, because God has not yet been manifest in the flesh.
Can you read the second gospel in each and every Christian Bible? The gospel according to Mark, chapter 12, verse 29. And tell us, what did Jesus say?
Mark 12, 29, no worries.
12,
29.
What does Jesus say there?
Mark 12, 29.
What is the message from Jesus, Isa al-Islam, to us people? Let me tell you. Jesus said in the gospel according to Mark, chapter 12, verse 29, Jesus said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. So what does it mean? The Lord our God, that means the Lord God of the people and Jesus. And remember, Jesus is speaking, the Lord our God is one.
Okay, let me read it.
Yeah, read it. Yeah, say, read it. He had to open his Bible, I knew
it. Verse 28, so that you can understand. You Muslim, you quote the scripture, you don't read from the beginning.
Come on,
that's
verse 29.
You get everything wrong.
No, why?
I'm going to read.
Does one mean one?
I'm going to read from verse 28.
Read.
And one of the scribes came and having heard that they reasoning together and perceiving that he had answered them well and asked him, which is the first commandment? Remember, the one of the scribes asked Jesus, which one is the first commandment? And hear what Jesus said. And Jesus answered him,
yeah, Jesus
the
answered.
First of all commandment is, Hear, O ye Israel.
Yes.
The Lord our God is one Lord.
So Jesus said, the Lord our God means the Lord God of the people and Jesus. Jesus said, the Lord our God is one.
Don't change words.
Yes.
Don't change words.
I'm not changing. Did Jesus say the Lord our God?
The fact that Jesus said the Lord our God
is one.
Is one Lord. That doesn't mean he is not the Lord.
No.
Why do they call Jesus changing. Lord?
You're changing.
I'm not changing. We got evidence, we got proof
okay,
that Jesus is the Son of God.
Do you know?
And he is God.
Do you know the English language? Do you?
My dear friend, I'm not speaking Arabic.
Okay.
If I was speaking Arabic, you could ask
and
me.
And do you believe what Jesus said?
Of course I do.
So when Jesus said in the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 12, verse 29, in each and every Christian Bible, when Jesus said, the Lord our God is one.
Yes.
So what Jesus write?
I agree with you, sir.
So what Jesus write?
Jesus is the Lord and is God. The Bible
look at this.
Who
he changed
Jesus
it.
Is. In the book of Isaiah 53, and also in the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 1, even in the book of Revelation, it refers to us that Jesus is God.
Okay. Where does it say Jesus is God? Show me a verse in your... No, hold on, hold on. Show me a verse in your Bible where it says Jesus is God.
John chapter 1. I read it before, yeah. But it seems you don't listen.
No, it doesn't say
neither
Jesus is God.
Here, sir.
Yeah. What does it say?
It said, in the beginning was the Word.
Which John, chapter 1?
And the Word was with God.
Is that God?
Hang on, sir. And the Word was God.
Yeah.
All things were made by Him.
Okay.
And without Him was not anything made that was made. Also in the Quran.
Now one verse, hold on.
Jesus was the Word of Allah. And this is the very Word
that
came in the womb of Mary and became a baby.
Hold on. You just quoted, tell the people the true picture, the complete picture. Did you read from the Gospel according to John chapter 1 verse 1? Yes?
I have read it many times, as I told you.
But that's what you read, but you didn't tell.
But
now,
you see, Lord, I can read it again.
Did you?
For the sake
okay,
of
read
those,
it again.
For the sake
and
of
then
those,
let me ask
okay,
you.
John chapter 1.
Verse 1.
And listen very carefully. I'm going to read it.
Yeah. Listen
he
carefully.
Said, in the beginning was the Word.
Yes.
And the Word was with God.
Okay.
And the Word was God.
Okay.
Also in the Quran.
Okay,
they
stop
said,
there.
Hang on, sir. The Quran says, Isa was the Word of Allah.
Nowhere in
the Quran. Word of Allah.
Okay, hold on.
Hang on. Now listen. I will read it and read it until
you
absorb
stop.
It.
Stop. You had your chance. Let me tell you. Nowhere in our Quran does it say Isa al-Islam or Jesus was God. Nowhere in our Quran.
I got a Muslim
okay, hold on.
Who told me.
Hold on. Nowhere in the Christian Bible does it say that Jesus is God. Now this, hold on.
Okay,
let me finish.
Okay, all right.
So the Christian speaker, he quoted, and sorry I'm repeating it because it's very important. The Christian speaker, he quoted from the Gospel according to John, chapter 1, verse 1. The first few words quoted and then stop. In the beginning was the Word and the Word was with God. Yes?
Yes.
Okay, stop there. Who is the Word?
Don't finish everything
okay,
in the
stop.
First scripture.
Answer the
no,
question.
You don't stop it like
now,
that.
Look.
He said, in the beginning was the Word.
Yes.
And the Word was with God.
Right. Who is
and
the Word?
And the Word was God.
Okay. Who is the Word?
No, you don't want to hear that.
No, I'm asking you now.
Yes.
Who was the Word?
Jesus was the Word of God.
And
he
was
okay. Before
okay.
the world was created.
Hold on. And Jesus, who you say was the Word,
yes,
was the Word with God.
Yes.
So Jesus was with God.
Yes.
That makes two gods.
You see, because you lack understanding of who God is,
what do you mean?
You cannot say
it's
there's
clear.
One win here,
black
another
and white.
Win in Earlscourt,
okay.
Another win in Manchester,
okay.
Is the same wind that blows in every direction.
It talks about wind now. Come
I
back
want
to God.
To make you understand
okay,
because
okay.
you don't understand
okay.
who God
let's,
is.
Let's, okay.
You're just using fabrication
okay.
and imagination
hold on.
Of who the Creator
okay,
is.
Hold
you've
on.
Got no understanding, my dear.
We have.
No, you don't.
Listen to me now.
I challenge you,
listen,
you don't.
Listen to me now.
All right, okay.
So in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. So you are telling us that the Word was God, Jesus. In other words, in the beginning was the Word and the Word was with God. So the Word was Jesus. If the Word was God, And if that word was with God, so that makes two gods. Yes.
My friend, we got human beings. We got soul, body, and spirit.
Ah.
And if a human being dies,
yes,
he can never speak a word.
Look at that.
A word belongs to me when I die.
Okay, look at
me. The word is no more.
Hey, preacher.
I tell you, I'm trying to make people understand.
You won't.
You are confused yourself.
Your churches are becoming empty because you cannot.
Listen.
Okay.
There, in the Old Testament,
yeah,
he said there are three that bear record in heaven.
Three.
The Father,
yeah,
the Word,
yeah,
and the Spirit.
Okay, what Jesus...
Hang on, sir.
Yeah.
When God was creating the world,
yes,
the Bible tells us the Spirit of God moved in the firmament,
okay,
to open room for the Word to go forth,
okay,
and bring creation.
Can you stop
and
there?
Then God spoke and, okay, said, let there be light, and there was light.
Can you stop?
Which he doesn't, you don't have the thing in the Quran.
Okay.
That's why you
we
mix
do,
up,
we don't, no,
you
we're
confused,
not.
You don't have any idea
you're mixed
who God
up.
Is.
Okay. We Muslims know everything created, the galaxies, the planets, the human beings, the animals, everything which is creation has been created by one creator, we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Okay.
But why is it not written in the Torah?
Hold on.
Hang on, sir. It is written in the Torah, a Jewish book, the name that God has revealed to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and all the prophets, he appeared to them. But you can never find anything in the Quran.
Yeah.
God,
hold on. So, is it true that when Christians talk about God, they say that Jesus had a father? Is that true? Did Jesus have a father? Yes or no?
Not a physical father, because as well as the Muslim believe that Jesus was born of a virgin, so there would be no way,
okay,
Jesus can have a physical father.
Was,
and not only that, let me finish, not only that, the angels of God, Gabriel, came to Mary that you will conceive and you shall have a son. If God said something is going to happen, it has to happen.
Okay, the Creator who created everything, the Creator God Almighty who created everything, was he the father of Jesus? Yes or no?
Say that again.
The God Almighty, Creator who created everything, to you Christians, is that God, is that Creator, the God, the Father of Jesus? Yes or no?
You see, I want to explain this thing so that you can understand it.
Yeah, go on.
I said before that there are three witnesses, three that bear witness in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Spirit. And don't think,
Jamal,
you are interfering.
Jamal,
you see this?
Jamal,
interfere.
Allah bless you.
He interfered. Now you can't.
Okay, no, he won't. Okay, come on. So
as I say,
yeah,
there are three that bear record in heaven.
Yeah,
the Father, the Word, and the Spirit.
Okay.
But you can say one Father, two Word, three Spirit. God is a supernatural being. He can never be counted like you are counting figures or substance, trees, human beings.
Okay.
But not only that, when you read the Gospel of John chapter 1,
okay,
it says
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God.
Okay.
And the Word was God.
And the Word
all
was.
All things were made
so
by
that
him.
Makes two gods. One is God and one
two,
is the Word.
Father, it's not two.
Okay.
We are talking okay. about supernatural.
Can I tell
it
you?
It can never be counted.
Okay. Yeah, give me a. Thank you very much. Okay. We Muslims say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything. As a Christian, do you believe, do you say that Jesus created everything? Yes or no?
According to the scripture,
yeah.
Jesus created everything.
So, brother, so according to you Christians, did Jesus create the galaxies?
Yes, he created everything.
Okay. So, do you believe in your Bible? Yes?
If I don't believe in my Bible, then let's wait for them to. Okay.
Okay, now in your Bible.
Might be we go to the other side now.
That guy is creating hatred. We don't need that.
Yeah, but he swore at my mother. Nobody swears at my mother, man. Come on. Yeah, come on. Yeah. Anyway. Okay. So, we came away from that place because other people started arguing with each other. And we want to speak to each other nicely without any insults. The way it should really be. And okay, so I'll just come back to what we were speaking about. And I said that everything is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We Muslim believe it's God Almighty. And I ask you, did God, was Jesus God? You said yes.
Yes, he
okay.
is God.
So we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything, the galaxies, the planets, the human beings, the animals, everything which is creation has been created by one creator, one almighty, one God, that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, as a Christian, sir, do you believe that, you do believe that Jesus was God? And because you believe Jesus was God, do you believe that Jesus created everything?
Yes, according to the scripture, yes.
Okay.
Everything that the scripture tells me, I believe, yes.
Okay. But sir, we Muslims, we have to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay. And as Christians, you do believe whatever Jesus said, yes?
Of course.
Right, a bit more loudly, yeah? Thank you. So you said Jesus was God Almighty. You said Jesus created everything. So in each and every Christian Bible, in the Gospel according to John, which is the fourth Gospel in each and every Christian Bible, in the Gospel according to John, chapter 5, verse 30, Jesus is quoted as saying, "By myself, I can do nothing. I judge as I hear, and my judgment is just, for I seek not to please myself, but him who sent me." Sir, as a Muslim, I believe that verse in the Bible, which yes, I've just quoted. Sir, as a Christian, do you believe what Jesus said?
Yes, I do believe.
So, you said Jesus created everything.
Yes, he did.
But when Jesus in the Bible himself is saying,
yes,
in the Gospel according to John chapter 5 verse 33, Jesus is saying, "By myself I can do nothing. I judge as I hear, and my judgment is just, for I seek not to please myself, but him who sent me."
Yes.
Sir, was Jesus God?
Yes, he
so,
was God.
So, sir, according to this verse which I've just quoted, if Jesus was God, then who sent Jesus?
I will tell you, I've repeated this several times.
Thank you.
That there are three that bear record in heaven.
Yeah.
The Father, the Word, and the Spirit. But the Word was manifest in the flesh.
Yeah.
That is why the flesh Jesus is telling us that he cannot do anything by himself, but what the Father tells him, and also in the book of Acts, he said, God was in Christ, the flesh Jesus.
Okay.
That he to reconcile the world unto himself.
Thank you very much.
So because God became flesh as a man, and the flesh has to obey the spiritual being in himself, in
okay.
Christ Jesus.
Thank you very much. So many times it's mentioned in the Bible, many times Christian speakers speak out, and it's written in the Bible many times that Jesus was Son of Man, Son of Man, Son of Man. So is it true that Jesus was Son of Man? Yes or no?
Yes, it's true in the fact that he came in the womb of Mary, and Mary gave birth to Christ.
And was Jesus
and
Son of...
As a matter of fact,
yeah.
Usually when a child is born,
yes.
They always refer to the father.
Okay.
But they use that in the fact that Mary gave birth
yes.
to a child. That's okay. why they call Son of Man.
Did Mary give birth to Jesus? Yes.
Yes, she did.
Did Mary give birth to God?
The Son of God, yes.
So Mary gave birth to Son of God.
He gave birth to the flesh that God dwelt in. Jesus' body was like a house that God dwelt in.
So was the birth of Jesus a virgin birth?
Of course it was.
So if the birth of Jesus was a virgin birth, that is with a mother, without a father, mm-hmm. and if the birth of Jesus was a virgin birth, then how can God be the father of Jesus?
Well, it is because God sent the word,
yeah.
and the word came in the womb of Mary, and Mary gave birth to a child.
So,
and also I quoted before, that is written that his name will be called Emmanuel.
Okay.
And Emmanuel means God with us.
Okay.
God came down in the flesh, in
so,
the form of Jesus.
So let's
Christ.
Come back. So many times in the Bible it's mentioned about Jesus, Son of Man, Son of Man, Son of Man. Is that true?
Of course it is true.
Sir, was Jesus a man?
Jesus was partly man and God.
When on the earth, was Jesus partly man, partly God?
Yes,
or on
he was.
Earth?
He was.
Was Jesus on earth 100% man?
100% man and 100% God.
So why did you earlier on say that Jesus on earth was partly?
100% man and 100% God.
So why did you say he was partly?
I'm trying to let you know this is
okay.
the best explanation
okay.
I can give it to you so that you can understand.
So Jesus was 100% God, yes?
Yes, and 100% man.
Right. So is God, we Muslims believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, is always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always God Almighty.
Yes.
Was Jesus always God?
Yes, he is always God. Though he came in the flesh,
yeah.
but yet he is God. I can
so,
give you example.
Yes.
You can never find a man who is able to walk on the Sea of Galilee.
Yeah.
Jesus did walk on the Sea of Galilee, and not only that, he raised many people from the dead,
okay.
and he cleansed the lepers,
yeah.
and not only that, when he died, he rose from the dead, he ascended up in heaven,
okay.
and he's going to come back again.
So Jesus was 100% man, yes?
I told you 100% God, 100% man.
On earth, was Jesus 100% man?
He was 100% God and man.
So on earth, Jesus was 100% God, 100% man?
Yes, sir.
So when Jesus was crucified on the cross,
yes,
was man Jesus crucified?
The flesh was crucified.
So Jesus was crucified.
The flesh, man was crucified.
So
yes.
on the cross, was God Jesus crucified?
I tell you, the flesh was crucified.
So
you cannot crucify supernatural being, a
yeah.
spirit can
okay.
never be crucified.
Okay.
For instance, my friend, when your physical body or our physical body dies, our spirit cannot die, it will live. We got a spirit in us. If somebody crucify you and I today, our flesh will suffer, but our spirit cannot suffer.
Okay, so is God Almighty? We say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is immortal, can never die. Was Jesus immortal? Yes or no?
The Bible tells us God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself.
Yeah.
Jesus as a flesh,
yes,
he was not immortal because he bare the flesh and there is limitation in the flesh. Mm. But not only that, because brother, he is 100% man,
okay,
and 100%
okay,
God,
okay,
he can manifest anywhere he want to manifest.
Is God Almighty always God Almighty?
Of course, he's always Almighty.
And was Jesus always God?
Yes, he is always God.
So if Jesus was always God, and when Jesus was always God, was Jesus always Almighty?
Yes, he is always Almighty.
If Jesus
so
is...
So he had to,
yeah,
fulfill the law.
Okay, can I just
he
ask
had
you?
To fulfill
Thank
the
you
law.
Very much. If Jesus was always God,
yes,
if Jesus was 100% God, if Jesus was always Almighty, how did he die?
Well, Jesus came on earth to die for the sins of mankind. He allowed himself to be crucified.
Okay.
Let me remind you, when they came in the Garden of Gethsemane, they asked, they sent Judah that go and point to us who Jesus is, because the Roman soldiers, they didn't know him that well. So Judah went and kissed Jesus, and that was a sign to show them that it is him.
Okay.
And then when they came to arrest him, they said, we want Jesus Christ of okay. Nazareth.
No, brother,
and
hold on, sorry.
When they came to Jesus,
sorry, brother, there are other people
fell
there.
Down on their back. They couldn't even touch him.
Okay.
But he allowed himself to be arrested.
Okay. Can I give you a verse from your Bible? And you do say you believe in the whole of the Bible, yes?
Boy.
Okay. Can I give you a verse from the Old Testament? There was a prophet by the name of Habakkuk.
Yeah.
And there is a book in the Old Testament by the name of that prophet, the book of Habakkuk.
Yeah.
Now, in the book of Habakkuk, in the Old Testament, chapter 1, verse 12, it says, my God, my Holy One, you will never die. So in the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, verse 12, it says, my God, my Holy One, you will never die. Is this true?
Yes, it is true.
So God can never die.
God can never die, but the flesh had to die because of crucifixion. And not only that, this flesh had to die so that mankind can be reconciled to God.
Was the flesh of Jesus holy?
Of course it is holy, otherwise God cannot dwell in.
But in the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, verse 12, it says, my Holy One, my Holy One,
yes,
you will never die. So in your Bible it says, my Holy One.
Yes.
So body of Jesus was holy.
It is holy.
So
yes.
How did the holy and body every, of Jesus die?
And every Christian who is around today on earth,
yeah,
they are holy.
Yeah. So why did
but their physical body can die?
Yeah. But if
but the holiness of God in them cannot die.
But in the book of Habakkuk it says, my Holy One.
Yes.
My Holy One, yes, you will never die. So
yes,
how did the holy body of Jesus die?
You see, they are talking about a super natural God who is holy, who is perfect, who is righteous. But this is the body,
okay,
that the Holy Spirit came in.
Yeah. Okay.
And he lived on earth.
Okay.
He allowed himself to die. Otherwise, nobody could touch him.
But is God immortal?
God is supernatural.
Is he immortal?
Supernatural.
No, answer my question.
I'm not going to answer the way you want it.
No,
he
no.
He is a supernatural,
okay, okay,
God.
We say, we Muslims say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is immortal. We say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can never die. Okay? Now, because he's the creator, he's God Almighty, he's immortal, he can never die. Do you believe that the immortal can die?
I don't believe it in a Muslim perspective way of believing.
Okay, was Jesus immortal?
I believe
immortal?
It according to the scripture, okay. Not your way.
So was Jesus...
I don't believe it your way.
Sir, was Jesus immortal?
Well, my friend, I've told you several times who Jesus is, and my guidance
answer
is
this
the
one.
Scripture
answer this
that
one.
Refer and tell us
yeah.
who Jesus is.
But was
it's
Jesus...
not the way you tell me
but,
or ask me
but was
about
Jesus,
who Jesus is.
Sir.
The Bible tells me
yeah.
he is the Son of God,
okay.
and the angel came and confirmed that God was on earth.
So Jesus...
And the word Emmanuel means God
sir,
with us.
Sir, thank you very much. I won't take much more of your time. Did you just say that Jesus was the Son of God?
Jesus was the Son of God because God was manifest
okay.
in the flesh.
Thank you.
It is the flesh that
Thank
is
you.
Called the Son of
right.
God.
Right. So you just said, sir, that Jesus was the Son of God. Now,
yes, he, don't, yes,
okay.
he was the Son of God.
Right. And was Jesus God himself?
I told you Jesus is 100% God and 100% man. The
so,
reason, the evidence is, how can a human being just walk on the sea?
Okay, all right.
Hang on, sir.
That's something else.
When,
miracles.
No, it's not something else.
We're not
this
going to miracles.
This is our evidence.
Okay.
This is our proof.
Yeah.
And this is something
okay.
that will show and open your eyes that this Jesus was not a man like you and I.
Okay.
Who are capable of making mistakes.
Okay, do you eat? Do you eat?
Do I eat?
Yeah.
My friend.
Food.
Even a child of 5 years old knows what
Did
he
Jesus
eat.
Eat?
Of course he ate.
So was he like you and me?
Not like you and me.
Do you
because
drink?
Because you can never walk on...
Hold on. Do you drink?
You can never...
Did Jesus drink?
You can never heal
okay.
the sick.
Okay.
So
you,
it's
hold
not
on,
like you
hold
and
on,
I.
Hold on.
It's
sir,
different.
Sir, do you pray?
Do I pray? Of course I do pray.
Did Jesus pray?
He prayed to show those who believe how to pray.
And what Jesus...
He came to demonstrate
sir,
God's ways to you and I.
Sir, do you pray to God?
Yes, I pray to God.
We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sir, did Jesus pray to God?
I'm going to ask you one question. This Allah wa ta'ala, what, how do you call it Allah?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yeah.
This Allah... Why is not written that Allah appeared to Moses, appeared to Jeremiah, appeared to Elijah, but they gave the name of God, Yahweh or Elohim?
Okay, did you
so
just...
So where did this Allah come from?
Okay, let me tell you.
It's
hold
not
on.
The
hold
God
on.
Of the Bible
Your...
is a different
okay,
God.
Okay, hold on.
Go
come
ahead.
Back to Jesus. He's same God, only one almighty God.
It's
okay,
not the same.
Hold
it's
on,
not the
hold
same.
On. All
I
these...
challenge you, my brother.
Hold on.
Allah is not the same with
okay.
Yahweh,
okay.
Elohim.
Okay.
He's different God.
Why is it that millions of your Arab Christians in Lebanon and in other parts of Middle East, when they mention God Almighty, those Christians say Allah?
Yes,
are they
I agree
wrong?
With you.
Are they wrong?
They are calling the Allah in the Bible, not the one in the Quran.
Okay.
So there is a difference.
But Allah, they are calling
the
Allah. Allah is
Quran
Allah. Okay.
And the Allah in
okay.
the Bible.
Okay.
So it's different.
Okay.
My brother.
So you said Jesus was God. Yes.
I've told you several
yes.
times.
And you said
and the Gospel
and,
of John chapter
okay,
1,
okay.
verse 1 confirms.
And you
that
said
he is God.
And you said Jesus prayed. Yes.
Of course he did.
Did Jesus pray to himself or did Jesus pray to God?
In the book of Acts it says, God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself.
Okay.
Did, so that gives you the right answer for
okay.
your question.
Is it true that you said that Jesus created everything?
Yes, in the Gospel of John chapter 1 verse 1,
yeah.
he said in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God.
Okay, okay.
And the
we
Word
don't need to repeat
God.
It. Okay, so
because
if...
you are asking the same thing
if,
that we are
No.
About.
I would go to a different side. So okay. if Jesus created everything, what did God the Father create? Nothing.
You know, that is the understanding
you lost.
Of what you know about God.
No.
In an Islamic perspective, you can say that. But in a Christian or biblical perspective, we depend on what the scripture tells us who God is.
Okay.
I may not agree with what God you worship,
okay,
but I only stick to my scripture and agree what the scripture tells me.
We Muslims love our Quran, Holy Quran, is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a Christian, do you love your Bible?
My dear friend,
do you believe in your Bible?
It's not about loving the Bible, it's believing what is written in the Word.
So do you believe in what is written in your Bible?
If I don't believe, I won't discuss with you or debate with you.
Last words before we finish for today.
Okay.
Very important. Last words. You did say Jesus was God, yes?
Brother,
just one more time.
You are repeating yourself.
Okay.
In each, something new.
Okay. Here's something new.
Okay.
In each and every Christian Bible, in the New Testament, in the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 26, it's Peter, the disciple of Jesus, is writing. When God, listen carefully, when God raised up his servant, who is the servant? Jesus. So Peter the disciple is writing in the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 26. When God raised up his servant, Jesus.
Who did God raise up?
Excuse me, I'm
God raise up.
Hold, I'm talking with
God raise up.
Sir,
if you
sir,
plant a seed,
sir,
it grows,
sir,
who plant the seed?
Sir, sir, you're an Israelite.
Raise up someone,
sir,
to do a certain job.
Okay.
What's
sir,
the problem?
Sir,
what is the problem with the job?
You're an Israelite, I am Muslim, he's Christian.
He's
this
Israelite too.
He's not Israelite. Sir, are you a Christian?
I his question.
Okay. No. This is a knockout verse. Sir, the manners are
you're when Muslim, but you probably you're not even Arab.
Are sir, Arab? My forefathers were Arab.
Exactly.
So I am from Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu.
And you're a Muslim.
Asadullah.
He's Christian.
So hold on. Hold on. Sir, the manners are when two people are speaking,
he's a Christian, you listen. Christian, so we are the same faith.
Now you said he's a Christian, before you said he's an Israelite. Hold on.
Not
so you went wrong. You went wrong. Before you said he's an Israelite, just now it's on camera, you
are
said he's a Christian.
Are you Muslim?
Alhamdulillah.
Exactly.
From head to toe, like don't I look like a Muslim? Okay, sir.
Arab.
Sir, please.
You're Arab man.
Yes.
So what?
From Ishmael.
So what?
Nothing. So defend Ishmael. Don't defend, like, why you aren't always.
Are you my teacher? Hold on, I'm old enough to be your grandfather. You're
West.
Telling me what
this
to do. Hold
you
on.
Change all the West. You cannot change the West.
In the debate I had you.
We are Christians.
In the debates I had with you, I knocked out your argument. Hold on. Sir, our last words.
Ruined the Middle East.
Sir, who's ruined the Middle East?
The Muslims.
The oil comes from the Middle East.
No,
without the oil,
no,
where will you
West.
Go?
Listen.
Quiet, man.
No, you just learned to speak English.
No.
Did you do a life in the UK test? We are in the West. You're coming over the West and you're telling us what to do.
I have trained people.
Hey,
hold on. Israelite.
This is the West.
Don't waste time. Hold on.
It's the right way.
Hold on, quiet.
Come over here.
Yeah, you be quiet.
Let me. You come over
excuse
here in the
me, excuse no, me. Where's the manners?
How did I come over here?
Are bhaiya.
This is my country.
Are bhaiya.
How did I get here? How did I get here?
Hey, brother, take him up further down. Jazakallah. Okay, sir. Excuse me. May Allah bless you. Okay, sir. Sir. Where were we? Okay. Okay, so.
Another country, and then you're coming here and you're telling us how.
Are you English? Look, he's coming from somewhere else as well. Okay, sorry, just last. Okay, hold on, just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. Just. Yaar, chodo isko.
How did my forefather get here?
Hold on.
How did they get here?
Iska dimag nahi kaam kar raha. Theek hai, iska dimag nahi kaam kar raha. Okay, hold on. Nice language.
It's a question.
Hold on, nice
how
language.
How did my forefathers get here?
Okay, hold on. Okay, last words, yeah? Jazakallah. Koi baat nahi, jazakallah, jazakallah. May Allah bless you. Thank you very much. You can stay there, okay? Okay, last words before we finish, okay? Now, sir, because you believe in the Bible, can I talk to you later on, a few minutes, yeah? Thank you. May Allah bless you. Okay, sir, last words I want to quote to you from the Bible. And then we'll finish because we have been speaking a long time. Assalamu alaikum, brother. You okay? Okay. So, in the book of Acts, we were interrupted by an Israelite who started talking and he won't stop. I had to step down and things are back to normal now. The Israelite has gone. Okay. And no more shouting. Okay. So, the last words which I already quoted, let me quote again. Sir, in every Christian Bible, in the Old Testament, in every Christian Bible, in the New Testament, in the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 26, it says, when God raised up his servant, Jesus, Peter is saying, Peter, the disciple of Jesus is saying, when God raised up his servant, Jesus, he sent him first to you, to bless you, by turning each of you from your wicked ways. Sir, in this verse, it mentions Jesus as a servant of God. Sir, is it true that Jesus was the servant of God? Yes or no?
The angel told Mary that you will bear a son.
Yes.
And his name shall be called Emmanuel.
Yes.
That means God with us.
Okay.
I've repeated that thing for several times.
Okay.
You seem you not understand it.
No, but
not
this.
Not only that, Jesus asked the 12 disciples.
Yes.
He said, who do men think that I am?
Yeah.
Some of them say, you are the prophet.
Yeah.
You are Elijah, or you're a teacher.
Yeah.
But Jesus said, but what do you think, you my disciple? What do you think about me? Who do you think I am?
Yeah.
They didn't know.
Okay.
None of them knew.
Okay.
Except by the Spirit of God
okay.
that came upon Peter.
Okay.
The same Peter who wrote that, he said, you are the Christ, the Son of the Most High God.
But it didn't say you are God yourself.
The Son of God is God.
Okay, now listen. But there's only one God. Okay, come back to this. According to this verse, you just quoted Peter as well, the disciple of Jesus. And Peter himself is writing this. And he says, when God raised up his servant Jesus. So is Peter writing the truth? Was Jesus the servant of God? Yes?
Jesus is God and he is the Son of God on earth.
But in this verse it says Jesus was the servant of God. Is
you
this
see,
verse true?
Peter by the Spirit of God trying to explain things.
Yeah.
To those who are listening.
Okay, last question.
But we have to depend on the word of Jesus.
Okay, last question. Was Jesus servant of God? Yes or no?
Jesus was the Son of God, not a servant of God.
So is this verse in the book of Acts chapter 3, verse 26, written by Peter, the disciple of Jesus, is this verse wrong?
You need to ask Peter if you had a chance.
How can I ask Peter? I'm living now.
The scripture tells us about who Jesus is.
But it's written in English. Do you believe what's written in the Bible?
I believe what is written in the Bible.
Okay, open book of Acts.
You understand the term Peter used as a servant.
Okay, open the book of, can you open your Bible, book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 26, sir, please?
You're ready, there's no problem.
I want to read, if it's in your Bible, why don't you believe that it says that Jesus...
Remember, God was manifest in the flesh.
No, was Jesus a servant of God?
God was manifest in the flesh.
Read to me.
And the flesh Jesus had to do... what the Father tells him to
do. Open the book of Acts chapter 3 verse 26. and read it out to us, where it says that God, that God sent his servant Jesus.
I will tell you this before I open.
Yeah.
Jesus said, no one knows the Father except the Son. And no one knows the Son except the Father.
So did the Son create everything or did the Father create everything?
I tell you, it's not about creation.
It
who
is.
Knows who?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created
who
everything.
Know who.
So
Jesus is the one who said, nobody can know me except my Father.
So did Jesus?
I'm one brother.
Yeah.
Nobody can know my Father.
Okay.
Except
read that
me.
Last verse. I'm running out of time. Read that last verse, please.
Mark chapter 3.
Verse 26, where it says, when God raised up his servant, Jesus. So Jesus is not God, he's the servant of God.
3 verse 26.
Yeah, read it loud.
Unto you first, God having raised up his His son Jesus.
I said son there.
His son Jesus.
Okay.
Send him to bless you in turning away everyone from their sin.
Okay.
My scripture says,
okay.
Raise up his son Jesus.
Okay. Why is it?
Why are you saying, son?
Hold on. You said in the King James version is written son. Okay, God raised up his son. Now,
that is a good translation.
Now, is the Bible in your hand, the King James' version of the Bible, Protestant version of the Bible, is that the true version?
The Bible, this is the true word of God.
Okay, I have a Holy Bible, NIV, New International Version. Sir, can you read in this one?
You have read it.
No.
Haven't you?
So tell me, in this one it says, God raised up his servant. In that one it says God raised up his son. So which Bible is right, that one or this one?
NIV, they have changed a lot of things. Okay. When you compare King James Version and other version, it remains the son of God.
Okay.
And
but
I tell you what.
This is the best-selling version of the Bible, NIV.
People can translate and make Bible to make money. That's what they are doing.
So
that's why NIV, the publication of this book, which many of us Christians don't accept, we don't rely on them because they have taken words out of the original manuscript.
Okay, let's stop there.
I don't believe in NIV.
Okay, let's stop there. Thank you very much.
Thank you, my
so,
friend. God willing, next Sunday.
Yeah, hopefully.
Okay,
and
wonderful.
Yeah, thank you very much for speaking to me.
Thank
and
you.
Have a nice time and enjoy yourself.
Thank
and
you.
I let me salute you. You have nice manners.
Thank
yeah.
You.
Thank you very much. Okay, this is how it should be.